Greetings, everybody. Battery H back for another episode of Interstate Adventures. We're here at Gulf Coast Logistics, or with Gulf Coast Logistics, and we are going to find a job out of San Rafael. So let's hop in the cab and get going, shall we? We'll fire things up here. Okay. Get rid of the old parking brake. I've already gone and selected our job. Okay, there we go. And we'll be leaving San Rafael. We will probably have to sleep on the way, but if we do, it's going to be kind of tight. So we'll make things interesting for ourselves. But first we have to run on over to the... I believe we're running from fields to fields. We're running some tire or some fertilizer. So we're taking more poo. More poo for us. Isn't that wonderful? And we'll be leaving San Rafael with that. And heading down into Central California. But we'll see that when we get there in just a minute. I hope you're all doing well. If you're interested in what mods we're using, you'll find those down in the description. I should have them for this video. We're still in the public beta for ATS on this bit, so we're still still trying out some things. I'm looking for into some other mod packs and things for this series, so don't think that you're going to see the same old stuff all the time. We're going to start expanding out a little bit here. Now that we've got a few missions under our belt. And we'll bring Gulf Coast Logistics into the real world. Still looking forward to the New Mexico release. Oh, no, it's 55 through here. Okay. We're alright. What am I doing? Driving like a granny. It doesn't matter because there's still one of my competitors ahead of me. Noon. I could probably do without the headlights. I should say it's just afternoon. The 35 through town here into San Rafael. And of course there's a construction zone. Well, that's okay. Coastline mining. Well, while we're pulling into San Rafael, you know, let's talk about the town for just a minute. Some interesting things about San Rafael that I found out recently I wasn't aware of. People who lived out there realized that a lot of these California cities and towns were formed off the site of old Spanish missions. Most of your sands are going to be that way. And San Rafael is no different. The missionaries came there because this area was the site of several Coast Miwok villages. And the town was named after the mission, which was founded in 1817 and named for the Archangel Raphael, who was the Angel of Healing. Now, what some of you true science fiction aficionados like myself are probably also aware of is that San Rafael was the home of Lucasfilm. Up until 2005, that is. When George Lucas came and filmed THX-1138, his first real film, it was filmed in San Rafael, and he sort of fell in love with the place. And eventually he would headquarter Lucasfilm and all of its subsidiaries, including Industrial Light and Magic, in the San Rafael area, and was one of the big... before the big tech boom hit a little farther south in San Francisco. And eventually the headquarters of those groups, including ILM, including Lucasfilm, were moved to San Francisco in 2005. So they're no longer here, and with the acquisition by Disney, well, you know, it's a little bit all over the place. But what it did lead to was something very interesting. With Lucasfilm came LucasArts. I don't know who remembers LucasArts, but I do. They were a very old video game producer, and I have gone in the wrong stinking entrance. Way to go, me. See, this game's gonna get more interesting every time you turn it on. Let's check my mirrors and... Thankfully, there was no traffic. Because here's the entrance with the little green bit. So LucasArts was here, and they were the producers of things like TIE Fighter that people know of. And Secret of Monkey Island and such. And they produced those games in this area. So there's our fertilizer load. Going to take that down to Huron, California. Okay, I have to find this bad boy. I think it says it's here to our left. There it is. I see the big yellow container right there. And as soon as I get this bad boy hooked up, I'll tell you the rest of the story about San Rafael before we get fully on the road. There we are, big orange carrying big yellow stinky. Let's get this show on the road, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take a quick look at our map first, eh? Okay, so they're calling for about a 5-hour, 42-minute journey, which is fine and dandy. But there don't appear to be any rest areas along the way, which could pose a problem for us because I think we're going to need to sleep somewheres. It's going to take us off the bridge. We could probably get a spot near Oakland here, though I'm not very confident about that one. And I don't know that we're going to, I don't think we can make it all the way to Huron and still get there in time. So we're going to mark just before we get to the city of Oakland and see what we look like there. Okay, let's get back on the road. And then the rest of the hidden story that is the tech life of San Rafael. In any event, with LucasArts and ILM and Lucasfilm, of course, all in this area, it actually became early on a hotbed for computer game developers. Once LucasArts was established. Most people don't realize that Borderbund software companies, the guys that are behind Choplifter, if you remember that game back in the early days of console gaming and whatnot, and Where in the World is Carmen Santiago and those games? That was all Borderbund software. They would be in San Rafael until they moved to San Francisco in 2001. And you'll start to see a pattern here as the tech boom in San Francisco took off. LucasArts, of course, was here and responsible for many of the Star Wars related games. Stormfront Studios was another name that you may have heard of. If you played Neverwinter Nights or were involved in any of the NASCAR racing series up through the early 90s, or through the mid-90s, that was Stormfront Studios. They eventually closed up shop in 2008. But perhaps the biggest game developer that most people have heard of today, and they're still active in San Rafael, is Telltale. Telltale Games, you know. The people that have done the Walking Dead series and the Borderlands Telltale series and the latest Batman Telltale series and things like that. They're still located in San Rafael. And they are a great studio. Not to take anything away from SCS, but they have a slightly different bent to their stuff. And I think it's conveniently wonderful that we have... okay, come on, make up your mind. Which lane would you like to be in there, son? I could have probably parked there, but... look at the junkyard off to our right and the pipes to our left. You see a world that's really in development, and it's not all, you know, prim and nice in some of these neighborhoods in and around Oakland, because here comes the entrance to 580. Onto the highway we go. See if I can still steer from outside the cab here. Not around big corners, obviously, but... oh, I think I gotta turn right here. 80 to San Francisco. No, I don't. Because only the computer keeps doing these things to me. And I should have looked and seen that that's what it was trying to do. Oh, I know what it is. It mistook... okay. It mistook where I placed the one. So we're going to reset navigation. And we got 2 hours and 42 minutes and 3 hours to get there. No, there's just no way we're going to make it there. So as much as I hate to have to make a bunch of this trip at night, I think we're going to have to make a bunch of this trip at night. Dang it, dang it, dang it. Because there come the yawns, my friends. There come the yawns. there's a rest area right there, but I think I'm going to go up and get some gas first. And we'll see if this stuff... Yep, there they are. As you can see now with the beta patch here, we now are not rolled into simply one potential fueling station. So when you're making these big UEs, you don't have to try and clip the signs trying to get in there. You can take them wide and... go into that second fueling island there. Just have to be careful not to clip the pumps. Get out at the old Chevron here and pump us full. The price of diesel up to $2.83. So they've been updating that a little bit. They've changed the economy ever so slightly. $197. Let's hop back in the truck and go grab a sleep. You also hear that pretty new coin noise. That's so much better than the old one, I think. It's not as offensive to the ears, let's say. Okay, now it's trying to push me back in the other direction, and I think that's probably a bad idea. Let's see if it will let me do what I really should be able to do, right? Just swing my truck around. Take a look. Not too bad. We'll take that parking space, eh? And get some nap. Alright, it's 2:30 in the morning. We've got 7 hours and 59 minutes to go, and it's telling us we've got 4 hours left on our trip. So I say we go get it. Alrighty, back in the cab, fire up the engine. I also think they've gotten the gearbox sound much more realistic. Off we go. Control on, and we will be on our way climbing through the California desert as we head south. If I've done my job properly, you'll have it slightly brighter than I do right now. Enough so you can see the hills. I know, I'm being quiet. I shouldn't be quiet. But it's a fun, and a nice drive. The only problem is that these idiots in front of me are not going to go fast enough to break out of, you know, short distance for me, and not go slow enough for me to actually pass them. Especially with said police officer that just passed me riding shotgun. Doesn't matter if we take a little extra time, but not a whole lot. Unfortunately, you know, we don't get any trucker chatter, but that's okay as well. Sometimes the beauty of the desert sky at night is often lost upon us. As much as I'd like to step out of the cab and look at it for a while, unfortunately, that would probably be hazardous to my health and hazardous to anyone who didn't want a trailer load of organic residue all over their car. One of these days, I think I'm going to have to take a trip for one of these loads to a farming simulator. Designated my farming sim farm or something. I'll be forced to take regular loads of fertilizer and seeds and stuff. Maybe remove produce. Too much further to go. It is right down 5 after all. Are going to keep passing, aren't they? But thankfully, there's not a lot of traffic at this hour. Apparently, half of them are police cars. Now, with what I've understand with the new public beta and Euro Truck Simulator, they have set it up so that the new police departments that they have in there cannot charge you with a ticket if you're not in the country that, you know, their car represents. Which I find fascinating. If they could import that to ATS, then you wouldn't have California patrol cars, for example, giving you tickets in Nevada, which is something that happens occasionally, especially if you start speeding right before the border, or right after the border, pardon me. They will ticket you, and it's like, you're not in my jurisdiction. Now, to be honest with you, I wouldn't recognize which, see, there's the Huron exit here. I wouldn't recognize which cars are police in which countries yet by a long shot, so I'm just going to go under the assumption that they can all write me tickets, which I've found is to be a very good assumption indeed, is a rule. In life in general. Come on. Had to horse this bad boy up a little bit, eh? Okay. Now we'll go into town here, and unhamper ourselves. I don't know that my buddy Jeff will be on duty. Maybe Jim. Jim may be working the night shift, so we'll have to check with our shipping agent when we get there. Passed up past the wind farm, and I can see the red flag destination now on our GPS, which is a good thing. Still 55 through here, though. We're not in Huron proper. Have discovered Huron. Okay, let's see where they want it. We may not take anything overly difficult. I think I know which position this is. Yep, it's that. It's that one again. The one that requires you to like double and triple and back it all into the. Getting out is almost as hard, I'll tell you. Okay. Let's kind of angle things back that way to start with here. Because you're not really looking to get everything in position. Just keep an eye on your other mirror. That's why I have this one up there. It's really for spots like these. And then we're just going to kind of angle her right at that back corner. And the idea is to put her in just before that. And then get the back end turned around. Not that quick, though. They'll accept that, I'll let them take it. It's not my best parking job, but then again, mostly in one fell swoop. A little pull ahead, but I won't take points off for style. So we continue to remain level 8 as an enthusiast. Let's hop back in and drive out of there real quick. Okay, facing forward. Park it right over here and go in and see the shipping agent for our money. And with that, everybody, that ends another episode of Interstate Adventures. I hope you've all had a good time. I certainly have. Found out a little more about San Rafael before this last time. Maybe I'll look up for something about here on. If there's something you'd like me to talk about, please leave a comment in the below. And I want to thank you all for watching. If you like the video, please a thumbs up. Subscribing would be even better. You can find not only the mods we've used today in the description below, but links to my Twitch and Twitter accounts as well. Until next time, everybody, have a great day and drive safe, please.